a lot of emotion at Baltimore City's council chambers tonight as relatives of a man who died while in police custody demanded answers. 11 News reporter George Lettis is live at City Hall with more on a hearing focused on the death of Tyrone West. George?
Well, Rod, what you're about to hear are the heartbroken and angry cries from a family desperate for information and charges in this case. You'll also hear from a police department trying to prove it's doing the right thing to get to the truth. From his sister.
So if y'all want to do anything for my family, get us justice. That's what we deserve. We will never have closure.
To his aunt.
And we're going to fight this thing, and we're going to fight it until the end.
To the woman he called mom.
What am I going to do now? They beat my child. They maced him. They tased him. They beat him so bad.
Relatives of Tyrone West poured their hearts out during a Baltimore City Council investigative hearing on the police custody death of the 44-year-old. He died during a struggle with officers following a traffic stop back in July. The hearing comes a day after the medical examiner released a partial report 5 months later that found a heart condition and dehydration were factors but offered no conclusion about the manner of his death. His family and witnesses at the scene that night claim West was beaten by as many as 9 officers who are on paid administrative duties right now. The state's attorney's office is still looking into the matter. It's why Police Commissioner Anthony Batts' testimony was void of details. He did say he's in the process of forming an independent board to investigate.
From the West family, to the citizens of Baltimore, to the members of the Baltimore Police Department deserve to know what happened.
Deputy Commissioner Jerry Rodriguez says what's called Maryland's Officer Bill of Rights has kept investigators from conducting detailed interviews with the officers.
Any officer that's involved in a criminal investigation where they are the subject of the criminal investigation can give a voluntary statement, but we cannot compel them.
Today, the mayor expressed interest in trying to modify that.
We're looking into how we can expand the questioning or the communication with officers and keep with their Bill of Rights.
It was an emotional hearing, but one with few answers about the death of West or why the medical examiner took 5 months to release a report.
My hope had been that we would be joined also this evening by the medical examiner.
But that didn't happen. No one from that office showed up. Now, I'm told after prosecutors decide what to do with this case, that independent police commission promises to get to work, and a report from them could take months. We're live at City Hall. George Lettis, WBAL-TV 11 News.